Okay, so today we'll continue some concepts that we started discussing last week about intelligent automation, the different types of automation, how automation is impacting the new world, this brave new world that we are living, instead of being a challenge for employment, now is a great opportunity because we have entire buildings, entire companies, with no people. And these many challenges that we are having, even for having the people working from home or for having people sick that cannot go to the office. And we continue some of the concepts that we started last week, talking about digital evolution, talking about data per se, when we need to automate something, we need to focus on data, we need to crunch and clean that data before starting playing or planning or deploying any strategy. So having the data is the very first step, and we'll focus on both on having that data and automating the many processes that we are having today. Most or companies in general grow acquiring other companies and having these many legacy systems out there with these different type of data not connected, people not talking to each other, and so on. So we'll talk today about automation and data blending, sharing some business cases, and also applying some concepts with a tool named Alteryx that is a very good tool for automation and also for data blending, data crunching, and all the different challenges that we are having these days with data and automation. So we chose Alteryx because it's a tool that is not free, but you as students or faculty can download and install this tool for free. Versus a traditional RPA software, this tool covers many challenges and also many different things that we want to do with data, like blending, like cleaning, like connecting different sources, like automating tasks, and so on, right? So this is something that covers, we like to mention always that we have four components that are, of course, the most important is the data, but we also have the processes, we also have the vertical, the business knowledge that we need to have around the different things that we are working with, and finally the technology, this like the upper layer, right? When we talk about this, we have culture. We always say that this is we need to have the data culture across the company versus the gut feeling decision making. We need to have, as we mentioned last week, everyone seeing the same picture and the people working with us empowered and allowing them to access this data and use this data for decision making and avoid those different escalations that we used to have in the past, right? So the culture of the data, what is automation, and finally measurement. Keep having metrics, keep measuring, and keep improving, right? Because we cannot improve and we cannot automate what we cannot measure, right? This is not a lecture, again. At any point, I don't know if everyone is allowed to talk, Stella, but if not, you can write your questions or comments in the chat, and Stella, feel free to jump in if you have any comment or anyone has any comment, right?
Everybody is open to unmute themselves if you have questions. I'll be monitoring the questions as well and pass them on to Sergio.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you very much. Yes, I'm not leaving time at the end for Q&A, so please, at any point, if you have questions, comments, or anything that you want to add, please be my guest. So, Alteryx, this is basically what we call the automation and analytics cycle, because we need to work with data, basically, for any work that we want to do with analytics, artificial intelligence, automation, big data, you name it, right? And always data, having the data first, and then having the data available to work with are probably the most important steps for any digital transformation, automation, or any type of strategy that we want to do for our companies. So the very first step is getting the data, finding a structure. Most of the data that we have these days are unstructured. We talked about, we discussed that point last week, when we have it's a saying that 20% of the data that we have in our data in our companies is structured, and the other 80% is unstructured, meaning that we have conversations that we are not capturing. We have audio files, we have pictures, we have videos, we have the social media talking about us, we have the press talking about us, we have conversation from our employees, from our customers, from the stakeholders in general. So we need that information is out there already, right? So we need to capture that information, we need to bring that information, we need to clean that information, and finally we need to make decisions supported by data and by the whole information that we have around, right? So find structure, creating data views, developing insights, and of course act, make decisions, and keep going. This is a cycle that never ends, right? Because we keep ingesting data into our databases, and we keep working with this until we have all this information. This is what we call the self-analytics culture. That is what we want to deploy for our companies, right? That is allowing everyone making decisions, not escalating decisions, empowering people, having data integrated without coding, no manual data preparation, no manual intervention that also brings or removes the possibility for human error, for a point of failure, and so on. Giving access to everyone, having open data and analytics, improving collaboration, having synchronic automatic workflows, eliminating the human intervention, eliminating the IT intervention. I'm an IT guy, but we need to probably empower everyone and not relying on IT and finance departments that they used to be owners of the data in the past, the data and the processes. And finally, having flexibility for scale these different type of solutions that will be deploying, right? That is the premise. That is a new world that we are living. So having or deploying an automation strategy is not an option anymore, right? This is something that we need to do to compete, to survive. I don't have time to see any crazy salesman. This is something that we probably see or hear every day, right? We are very overwhelmed with so many things. We are very busy. We are very focused on what is urgent and not paying attention to what is important. This guy could win a war with using a machine gun, but instead he prefers to fight with that tiny sword, right? That is something that we see every day, probably not paying attention to the big picture, right? Again, to close that idea, automation is basically connecting the dots, having the information aligned, eliminating silos, breaking those silos from the different sources that we have, instead having everything in one place, automated processes, and efficient business, right? About that, we have too many data sources these days. Even if we capture that data, or even if we not, again, sometimes that data is out there with different sources talking about us and creating information about us, and we need to use that data, right, for making the right decision. So I need to understand what we should be doing, this guy. Probably for that, first we need to have the data for decision making, right? And that is the very first step. The four V's of big data, you know the four V's, but sometimes the value is not linearly correlated with what we call volume, velocity, and variety, right? We have different type of data being generated at every second. The velocity is exponentially growing, like the volume. But sometimes having too much data, if we not take action, is useless, right? Sometimes it's overwhelming or even guiding us or leading us to making the wrong decisions, right? That's why we are aligned in this conversation, in this session today, what is analytics, what is data, what is cleaning, collecting data, and finally automating, right? And the steps are collecting the data, creating tools for analysis, getting the data that we need, interpret what are the questions that we want to answer with data, and finally present and share the data, having that data available for everyone in dashboards, reports, and so on. Any questions so far? Are we good, Stella?
No questions so far. We're good
nice,
to go.
Nice. About that, you can see here how the information is growing, and the projection of this growth is even more scary, right? Because what we see in light blue is the structured data, the traditional data that we used to see and we used to use, and we probably use every day. But look how fast and how much is growing the unstructured data. The unstructured data, again, is all the data that we have out there that is not in our databases, that is not in our data warehouses. To give you an idea, the data warehouses, a repository from different sources of structured data. A data lake, on the other hand, is having a structured data plus unstructured data. So there are many data lakes being created these days, and that is something that we also should do, right? We should collect that unstructured data, because we are probably missing many opportunities, right? And this is a very interesting moment that we don't want to miss any opportunity. So with these different tools that we are using for automating, we are collecting structured and unstructured data. Actually, we are going to share a case of a company, actually it's a university, let's pretend that is NYU, that is collecting data from people using social media. So we are scraping data from social media, we are capturing that data, and we finally are using that data for marketing campaigns. So the goal is moving our culture from organizations with many business units. We have many different business units, sometimes the same business units growing from M&As, growing from acquisitions, growing from other companies. And again, we have these many siloed legacy systems unconnected between them. Even sometimes for the same process, we have different data systems, and decision makers should go to one system for something, go to another for another things, no connections, no big picture, and no opportunity for improving. Long processes, manually done, many challenges with data. We mentioned this many times, that companies and decision makers sometimes need to double check, triple check everything that they are seeing, because they don't trust their eyes, they don't trust the information that they are seeing. They need to go to someone else to ask, to validate this information. They need to go to finance teams to give them the information that they need, and so on. And we are moving to a harmonized organization with having the process totally aligned in one place, short cycles, totally, completely automated with no human intervention or not human manually doing manual work, typing and fixing errors, and with dashboards and metrics. That is the ultimate goal, having the information that we need in the moment that we need it for making the right decisions. We need to be fast, we need to be flexible, and we also need to be agile, right?